Hello everyone. So in today's video, I want us to go through and see how we can be able to configure CAPsMAN. CAPsMAN is really essential in situations whereby you have several routers that you want to control and manage their wireless interfaces. And probably it's a cumbersome job or it's a tiresome job to go to each and every access point and do configuration to it. So CAPsMAN gives you that ease, that simplicity of doing all those configurations just from one point. So what I have with me here are two routers. My first router, which is the main router, I've given it an identity called CAPsMAN. And then I have a second router with me, which I've given it an identity and I've called it router one. So let's start the configuration. We are going to start with our first, the main router. So what you need to do is you just need to come to CAPsMAN, click on manager, and then click enable. So that is all that you need to do to enable the CAPsMAN functionality on your first router, which is going to control all the other routers that you have connected to it. So after that is done, let's close that. So let's come now to our second router. And on our second router, now all you need to do is you need to come to the wireless tab, then come and click on CAP. And just before I forget, this is a router which is it's in its default state. I have actually reset it and it has no configuration at all. So let's just see. Yeah, so as you can see, there's no configuration on this router. So after coming to the wireless tab, you come and click on CAP. Then we are going to enable this. And then our interface, the interface that we want to control is the vlan interface. Let me just widen this. And then our destination interface is going to be Ether2. Why Ether2? Ether2 is where my cable is connected to. The cable from the first router comes from, it comes from Ether4, and then it goes to Ether2 of router 1. So that's why I'm using Ether2. It can be Ether3, 4, 5, whatever port that you're using to connect to it. So I'm going to pick Ether2 as my discovery interface. And then I'm just going to apply that. Okay. So after doing that, you can now be able to see that router 1 is now managed by CAPsMAN. And then if we also come to our first router, click on CAPsMAN, you can now be able to see from the CAP interface there's a router that has been added. The name is CAP1. You can be able to change this name if you want to. If you come to remote CAP, you can also be able to see the same router that has been added. So that is all that you need to do. Secondly, I would also want to add my first router. I would also want it to be managed using the CAPsMAN. So for this same CAPsMAN router, it has a wireless interface. That wireless interface can also be managed from the CAPsMAN. So what you need to do is you just need to come to wireless, click on the CAP, and then click enable. And then now for this, you don't need to input the discovery interface. What you now need to do is to input the CAPsMAN address. This is going to be the local address of this same router. So it it's going to be 172.0.0.1. This is the same address that you would also use for your case. So after inputting that, we are going to apply this. Okay, and you can now also see that our local router itself is also being managed by the CAPsMAN within itself. So if we come back to CAPsMAN tab, you can now see we have two routers that we are managing now from this CAPsMAN. So that is how you are able to manage your routers. So a little bit more configuration into it. So you'd want a situation where you want maybe to change the SSID, you want to change the password and all that. Note that when you come, let's say you come to our router one, you can see it says that it's been managed by CAPsMAN. So even if you come to and open this, and maybe say you want to change this SSID, let's say maybe you want to, let's just use a simple word, test, apply, you see that you cannot be able to make that change because it's been managed from the CAPsMAN manager of our core router. So you need to note that. So what you need to do for you to be able to change the SSID and stuff like that, let's minimize this. You have to come to your main router, which is the CAPsMAN. Then there are two ways of doing it. The first way is you come to the router that you want to change the SSID or the password for. So maybe you come and click on that. Then you have SSID here where maybe you can put your SSID. You can also maybe input your country. Okay. I'm not finding my country. I'm not sure why. But this is how you are supposed to change your country. There it is. Then the type of installation, this could be indoor, outdoor, whatever use or whatever location the router is located. And then just click apply. Okay, this change is going to affect this particular CAP1 router. That is the first way of doing it. I'm forgetting to show you the security part. All you need to do is come to security, then authentication type, click those first two and maybe enter your passphrase as you wish. So that is how, that is the first way of doing it. The second way, you need to come to the configuration tab here, then click add, come to the wireless tab. SSID, let's give it maybe just anything, CAPS test. So that is going to be our SSID. Then what else do I need to choose? Everything looks okay, maybe the country as well, so that it goes in line with the regulations of your country. Let me just scroll down and look for Kenya. Okay. I'm not sure why I'm having difficulties finding it. Okay, just a minute as we look for it. Yeah, there it is. And our installation type is definitely indoor. Then for the security, you come to authentication type. I would check that. Then my passphrase, I would put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But definitely that is just for demonstration purposes. You need to put a stronger password. And one thing I also want you to take a note of is this name, CFG1. Basically short form for configuration 1. You can change that name if you want to. I've decided just to leave it as it is. So apply. Okay. So what I now need to do is I need to come to the CAP interface, and each and every CAP that I'm managing, let's say CAP 1, I would click that, come to the wireless section, then configuration, the drop down. You can now see where CFG is now coming from. And it does not only have to be one configuration. You can have maybe a particular configuration for first floor. You can have a particular configuration for second floor with a different SSID. So you'll just be going to the various CAPs and then choosing the configuration name that you've just created. So for now, because we only have one configuration, it's definitely going to be CFG1. Then apply that. Okay. We go to CAP 2, same configuration, it's going to be configuration 1. Apply that. Okay. So we've managed now to input SSID and username for our CAPs. So the next thing that I want us to do is I want us now to look at the security part of it, because as it is right now, anybody who has a configured, a reset router, and they just go to CAPs and they enable that. They come to CAP and then they enable this. This person is able, their router is now able to be managed using your CAPsMAN. So you want to have a situation where you have a bit of control on who is getting connected to your network. So what you would do is that you would come to your CAPsMAN router, come to manager, and then let me just make this a little bit smaller. And then on the certificate here, just make that auto. CA certificate, also make that auto. Then click apply. Give it a minute also so that it generates those certificates. And once the certificates are generated, they will be populated right here. You can see they've now been generated. So you can now see that the certificates have been generated, so click OK. And then after doing that, you now need to come back to your routers, and let's go to the first router. Then you need to come and click on CAP, certificate, click on the drop down, and then pick request. Then apply that. And it's going to make a request so that it gets those certificates. And once that is done, the certificate is going to appear right here. As you can see, it has already appeared. So click OK. You can now see the router is still being managed by the CAPsMAN. That is the first part regarding security. Another thing that you now need to do, after you've requested for the certificates for your routers, maybe in first, second floor, what you now need to do is okay, I haven't requested for my local router. Let me just do it. Wireless CAP request. That one I have done. Okay. Let me go to the CAPsMAN manager, the wireless interface, and also do a request, certificate, request, apply. Let's give it a minute so that it gets that certificate, and you'll just see it populate at the requested certificate over here. Yeah, you can now be able to see that it has also been given a certificate. So you apply that. So now, guys, when you come back to the CAPsMAN and then go back to manager and then click require peer certificate. When you click on that, when you enable that, click apply. Okay. Nobody else is now going to be able to receive a certificate from CAPsMAN. So if anybody else comes with a router and tries to plug it in, maybe somewhere where you have a switch, that router will not be managed by our CAPsMAN. That is one. Two, you can also go to your to the routers and instruct the routers to only get certificates from your core CAPsMAN router, which you know. So how do you do that? You come to CAPs, and then after that, just pick the certificate from the drop down, then click lock to CAPsMAN, then apply that. Okay. Let's go to the second one. We need to come to wireless, CAP, and then we are just going to do the same thing. The certificate, we are going to choose the certificate that it has been given, and as you can see, it's this one over here, 77D, there it is. Then enable that. That just click that checkbox, lock to CAPsMAN, apply that. Okay, it will also take some few seconds for it to get that setting, so it's back online. So when you come to our CAPsMAN and maybe have a look at our remote CAPs, you are able to see both of them, and the status is they are all running. So guys, that is how you are able to configure CAPsMAN. In case you have any questions regarding it, just leave a comment down below and I'll definitely answer each and every one of them. So guys, that's it for today, and see you in the next video.